the cap.
You're right.
Hey. Yo,
what up, Cap?
Wanna introduce you to this girl. What? Think I really love this girl. Man, she's so fine.
Shut up, dog.
She stand about 5'4", Coca-Cola, red bone.
Damn.
She drive a black Durango, license plate say Angel, tattoo on her ankle. And she's making pesos. Got a crib on P Street, right off 17th Street. And I call her TT.
Wait a minute, hold on, dog.
Do she got a kid?
She got some Waffle House.
Yep.
Do she got a beauty mark on the outside of her mouth?
Yeah.
Went to Georgia Tech,
yeah.
Works for the TVS.
Yep.
And I can't believe she.
Damn. Tell me what's wrong, dog. What the hell you damning about? I'm your homie, so just say what's on your mind.
Man, I didn't know that you were talking about her.
Oh, man, you telling me you know her?
Who I know her? Like a pastor knows his word.
We messing with the same girl. Same girl.
Could the love of my life and my potential wife
be the same girl?
Same girl.
Same girl.
Say, man, y'all know what's going on, man. We appreciate y'all. Welcome back to another episode of No Cap TV. It's your boy Hollywood Reek, and
it's your boy motherfucking YCM Mac.
Hey, man, and we back with it, you feel me? We back at it like a crack at it, and don't get act at it.
I'm talking about don't get act at it, don't get activated, you hear me? Hey, today I'm up to Hennessy, hey, man, you know what I'm
today,
saying?
As y'all can see, we not on no Twist of T's today. We on some cool little, you know,
we on some cool flair shit, man.
Like, well, he gonna be turned. I'm just, you know, I'm just
gonna be burnt up, man.
You feel me? Not too crazy.
They got snacks. I got Hennessy. You know, it's a little bottle, but it's just for me. You hear me?
Yeah. Little pickle.
Little Red Bull.
Yeah.
Little pickle. You feel me? I like pickles. I don't know about y'all.
Fucking with the pickles.
Feel me? Pause. Or not, all that bullshit. But I fuck with pickles. If you ever had a pickle, try this Chamoy one, bro. This that shit. I promise you.
Some Arizona West Coast shit for you. But hey.
Niggas don't know about this.
Ooh, they don't know about that one.
Niggas don't know about this, nigga.
Don't know about that one.
Yeah, what you got over here, man?
I, typical got on little side patch. Watermelon style.
You hear me?
Look, you know, look, pineapple. It was some pineapple.
Got that fake. You didn't pull up? Did you drop a four in that motherfucker?
No TV, you know, I tried to pull up, you know, just.
Did you pull a four in that motherfucker?
Not too crazy. You feel me? You know what I'm saying? But no, we chilling, man. We, like I said, we appreciate y'all for tuning in with us, man. It's just like week three. Hey, you coming crazy.
We coming crazy. We doing this shit, bro.
We doing this shit.
You feel me?
You feel me?
Consistency is the key. You hear me?
Yeah.
If you don't do nothing that I do, just be consistent as me. You understand me?
And going off what he just said, you're going to jump right into daily motivation.
Daily motivation.
Let's get it.
My daily motivation is, bet. A lot of you niggas want to, you know, skip the struggle.
Skip it.
When the struggle builds character.
It do.
If you don't go through nothing, how the fuck are you going to be something?
How you going
to
do it?
You know, even when you driving out of town, you got to drive there. You got to go through the mountains. You got to. You know what I mean? You might pop a tire. You might be some shit on the way.
Man.
It ain't always be a good route there, but if you skip the struggle, as soon as you make it to the top, motherfucker, take that, because you never know. You ain't got no structure. You ain't got no character. Struggle is a good thing sometimes. It's okay to struggle. And motherfuckers be hating and so worried about what the next person is going to say, which y'all don't know. The motherfuckers that's booing on the stand, they not even on the field.
Talk about it.
You know what I mean? Yeah. Motherfuckers that's booing the hate, they're not even on the field that you're playing. Fuck what a motherfucker got to say about you. You understand me?
I love that, man. And just to kind of piggyback off of him, my daily motivation, I'm going to say what I'm going to stick to and what I'm going to talk about and what I'm trying to, you know what I'm saying, perpetrate, penetrate, and push out. You feel me?
Perfect.
What I want to say, don't always be comfortable with what you're doing. You know what I'm saying? Because if you're comfortable, you're content. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Think about that. If it comes back, you can tell. If you're not outside of your character, or if nothing is uncomfortable to you, you're going to stay. God damn, that shit beat you.
That shit beat my ass.
Hey, shout out to my ass.
That motherfucker got me sweating already.
God damn, shout out to the plug. But look, staying consistent. Damn, he done threw me off. I'm high this bitch. He done smoked this bitch out.
This shit fire right here.
What I say?
I forgot what you was talking about.
Being uncomfortable.
Being uncomfortable,
man. You know what I'm saying?
It's okay.
It helps build character like he's saying because... If you're comfortable with something, you're never going to elevate. You're going to stay content. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Comfortable, content. Think of those words together because they go together. You feel me? They like Bonnie and Clyde, they go together.
Take the cap off.
Take the cap off.
The sky's the limit.
elevate.
You know what I mean? Elevate. Elevation, like you an elevator. You hear me? So you push that button, you're on the ground level, and you're trying to get to the top floor.
You feel me? Yeah. Just like, you know, anything, like it can be a new job. You relate this to anything. A new job, you know, a new relationship. You know what I'm saying? You don't want to be content. You want to think outside the box. You know what I'm saying? Because what it don't, you feel what they say? If it ain't broke, don't fix it. I understand what a lot of people say. Preach. But, you know what I'm saying? If you never experience outside the box, you'll never know what your potential could be. You know what I'm saying? You can never know how hard, how you can go. You feel me?
That's what they kind of mean when they say, get out the matrix. People be stuck in the matrix. That's just, you just stuck doing the same thing. It's so routine. You're comfortable. It's working for you. You feel like you're doing a little something. So, you know what I mean? But there's so much more to this world. That's why every single year, they make a brand new car. Right. It's the same car, but it's a new one to keep you wanting more and more and more and more things. You know what I'm saying? So...
that's how we coming, man.
That's how we bumming, man.
But, man, hey, go ahead and introduce the first topic of the day, you feel me? What are you doing?
The first topic?
Oh, excuse me. That mean you got this shit pulled up?
I ain't got it pulled up.
We freestyle off the top. What we going to jump into? Excuse me. We were just listening to R. Kelly. We going to talk about R. Kelly there. Fuck you. We're going to talk about R. Kelly.
That's the first topic. That's the first topic. Look, hey, I spoke this week. Hey,
look, that shit is beating his ass down. He supposed to be the motherfucking narrator in this bitch.
Weed will make you forget this shit. Don't smoke weed unless you got your shit together.
No, R. Kelly, man, it's crazy because me being right doing shit, I love R. Kelly, you know what I'm saying? Outside of what he was doing with the females and what that was going on, I mean, you cannot deny him as an artist, man. He's a great artist.
R. Kelly is that nigga. And don't nobody got as much hits as R. Kelly. I don't give a fuck who you is. Man. Don't nobody got as much hits as R. Kelly. And the cold part to me will make it so fucked up, you know. Mm. At the end of the day, yes, that's wrong. You was out here touching kids, nigga. Hey, I believe you supposed to get the motherfucking max, whatever. But if y'all gonna be on R. Kelly head like that, y'all need to get on all them old school niggas head like that. All them niggas used to be singing. If you listen to all them songs.
What's that song he was talking about?
You're not a little girl. You're a woman. What the fuck did you say?
You feel me?
Take my head. Keep Sweat.
Keep Sweat was a woman.
Hey, he's a dirty motherfucker, boy. a lot of you niggas, my nigga. And the shit crazy. We just got the supercar. Hey, T.Y. just pulled up. I hear that motherfucker.
Yeah, he did.
Motherfucker just pulled up. Shout out to YCMTY. That nigga just pulled up to, you understand me, No Cap TV. It's busting around this motherfucker.
So anyways, you feel me? But yeah, nah, y'all can't be on R. Kelly. Well, I accept what y'all saying about R. Kelly and stuff like that, but y'all can't deny him as an artist, you feel me? Because he was really one of them guys.
He's that nigga.
Yeah.
So. I don't give a fuck what nobody say. R. Kelly's that nigga. Don't nobody want to go no verses with him. No, none of that shit. And then I feel like everybody, I don't know if he did something to the, you know, Illuminati or whatever he did to them people to make them so mad, but... they on his app. Or what I do low-key feel like too, I feel like, you know, R. Kelly, he was taking care of all these girls. Mm-hmm. And after so long, you know, the money stopped coming and he can't stop taking care of them. And that's a way for a bitch to bash a nigga character. Mm-hmm. Oh, he raped me, he did this. Because if all that time he was taking care of you, you never told nobody. Why all of a sudden you just come out the woodworks today?
You know, it's exploitation of all.
These bitches, you living with R. Kelly. You with R. Kelly. You telling bitch, I'm with R. Kelly, bitch.
Oh God.
You ain't acting.
They mamas was probably letting them do that.
Bitch, you better go with bitch R. Kelly here. Bitch, get outside. Oh, that's God. Why you fucking piss on me. You know what I'm saying?
Crazy,
bitch, you with R. Kelly. That's why they was doing you with Kells, my nigga. So I feel like that's low key fucked up how they doing that. And if they gonna say like, oh, this nigga need to go to jail for the kids, and he was touching little girls and all that shit, because that was nasty if he was doing that shit, Mr. R. Kelly. Mr. Robert. That was very disgusting. You're touching fucking kids. I don't condone that nasty shit at all. But all them nasty niggas was nasty. If you just listen to any one of their music from that era, they always touching kids,
was
if you ask
me. Shit. You feel me?
They all was.
Yeah.
Especially coming from Chicago. Yeah, where we at?
I don't know.
We finna pause real quick. All right, we motherfucking back, to be exact. You understand me? Hold on. My name ain't Zach around this motherfucker. You hear me? Hold on. But hey, how you feel about that nigga Usher? You know what I mean? When that nigga Usher.
Usher Bucks?
How the fuck you feel about young Usher Gerb when he be at the motherfucking concerts and he be filling up on niggas' bitches and all that shit, dancing all on their booties and shit.
You feel me?
And then nigga be all on. He did that to Keke Palmer. Man. Her baby daddy was mad at the motherfucker.
That's that's Kiki Palmer's. Hey, she got her own motherfucking mind. You feel me? If your girl gonna, if she gonna go out and do some shit like that, you need a new bitch.
Oh God, you
know what y'all mad at Usher for?
What you mad at Usher for? At Usher? Why you being weird to me?
Oh God, hey, you know what I'm saying?
He had that bitch on stage, you like feel me? They and the, you know what's called? The internet kept playing it back and back and back.
Oh God, man, because Usher, you know, he just like Reek. Hey, it's your boy Hollywood Reek, and if you're a freak, you know what I'm saying? Keep away from me.
You might catch that bitch in the street.
In the streets,
fuck with me, the bitch gonna be in the street.
Look, man. You hear me? Ain't nothing wrong with Usher, man. He did his part. You know what I'm saying? Kiki Palmer was supposed to remain solid, and she didn't. She folded. So
she folded. Yeah. So look. So okay, most bitches get away, and they be like, "But it's Usher."
Nah, bitch.
How you mad about Usher?
She choked.
No nigga.
I don't give a fuck. No.
Bitch, hold on. You better know what type of shit is going on around here, bitch. I don't give a fuck who it is.
Yeah.
You understand me? Nigga groping all up on your ass and shit. Bitch, you ain't getting paid.
Hey. Right. If you ain't getting paid, you. Hey.
But it's Usher. But bitch, I'm me. Fuck you mean? Who the fuck is Usher?
Oh, God.
You might as well go be with that nigga or something. Hey, another thing, though, too. Hey, oh, I know. Another question. I wanted to ask you, bro. Like, everybody with the world with this snitching and all that shit, you think Gunna really told?
Ooh, shit. Hey, I don't know if Gunna told, man.
Think Gunna really told?
I mean, he was in, I ain't gonna lie, he had a video of him.
That nigga was in there, in, yes,
in the court. He thought that shit was coming on.
He thought they were.
He wasn't
that shit. Where was TMZ at in the fucking events? How did they get that footage out?
He thought that shit was not coming out.
So look, I've been hearing crazy shit like it was a story I heard about like a nigga, right? He snitched, or was it King Von? Some shit. If your homie is dead, is it okay to snitch on him?
I think
to like get you out of trouble?
Certain
like put the blame on him, not snitch or whatever, but just put the blame. You know what I mean? Put the blame on him. Put the blame on him. If he dead, like, how would you feel if he was dead and your homie put the blame on you to get yourself out of jail?
Yeah, he finna get out. As long as ain't no crazy ass shit, like, no, like you said, no kids, no raping and shit like that.
It's a body. It's some body. Crazy shit.
I smoked it. What you talking about? Tell on me.
You know me.
Who was motherfucking cat back?
So would you consider that snitching?
Hell no, that's not snitching because they can't prosecute a dead nigga. If I can say my homie like, you feel me? Nigga, I'm dead. What the fuck? What they gonna dig me up and prosecute me?
Hey, that's the real shit. I'm gonna say shit.
Only thing I understand.
Knock on wood.
Right. I understand how it can impact that nigga family though, the dead nigga family.
Yeah, cause they gonna put that on him.
Yeah.
Like he really did it, and you know they gonna
convict him. Even though he did it, you feel me? That's the only thing I see that, like, the cons behind that. But, nigga, hell no, I give this shit. I smoke this up.
Stupid ass boy. Hey, another thing I want to talk about. I want to talk about these motherfucking females, bro. You know, I want to talk about females. They want a rich nigga. They want a nigga that's spending that bag.
The bag.
You know what I'm saying? Is you a nigga that's spending that bag, or is you a nigga that's getting that bag? You understand me? What type of nigga is you? Because there's a lot of niggas.
I'm both of them niggas. I'm nigga getting the bag and spending the bag. Yeah. But you feel me? I'm not no tricking ass nigga though.
No.
If I fuck my shirt, like, it's cool, but like,
yeah, if you mop
these
it,
niggas is tricking.
Literally, for the pussy.
Tricking off the
first degree.
In the first degree, I'm talking about just pure soon they meet. They don't even know her, just instantly just tricking. Oh, what do you consider tricking?
Me? I feel like tricking is shit. Doing, spending, going above and beyond for a bitch that you don't know that you just trying to hit. You feel me? Like, I've been
spending your money on.
You feel me?
For some yan yan. You understand me? That's tricking, bro.
Tricking,
or just to have bitches around and you're spending your money. But, and it's different forms of tricking. You can trick your weed off. I know niggas that do that. Niggas trick their weed off. Nigga got a whole sack. Soon they meet a bitch. Hey, you smoke? I gotta.
Because they think that's what make them focus more.
I think that's why they do that. For sure, that's why they do that.
Sure,
and bitches is smart. Hell, nigga, you got to zip. Hell, come on, that's smart. That shit, they rolling up big backwoods.
But then that nigga can't be mad if she gonna do the same thing with the next nigga. Like, whatever your bag is content for the moment, but whatever nigga got the biggest bag, she gonna flop to. You know,
I don't want no bitch to fuck with me because I got some weed, because I got some money, because I got some nothing.
Bitch, I'm broke.
Oh, God.
Because you fuck with me.
Type shit.
Like, I'm fucked up. Like, can we come up together?
That's what's wrong with this generation, bro. It's fucked up because all the females, like, the mamas is teaching that, the kids is learning that. But none of these girls having no, they don't know what like how to be domestic in a relationship because they didn't grow with no father figure in their house. They mama still trying to, they mama 45 still in the club.
Still popping pussy, they damn self. That's the cold part.
That's the fucked up part.
They want a nigga, females want a nigga that's out their league, like, And then, nowhere they can, right. They can't even, they want a nigga that can provide shit that they can't provide for their damn selves.
And that's another thing, like, a nigga with a bag, fuck with, like, an average, like, a bag, a nigga that got a bag ain't really giving a fuck about if another bitch getting a bag, too. Like, he can put her in position to get a bag, but that shit not vice versa, nigga. If your bitch...
If a bitch got a bag, bitch ain't fucking with no broke nigga. Bitch ain't fucking with no broke nigga. A nigga will fuck with a broke bitch and put her in position. And turn that broke bitch, you know what I'm saying, put a wig on a pig and make her gig around this motherfucker. You understand me? Hey, but these bitches will not fuck with no nigga who ain't got no money, and that's the cold part. You understand me?
Well, I feel like so
broke. Go get you some money. But it is. But the nigga and the bitch, they both broke.
Damn.
That's what it be.
God, this hell.
You broke, I'm broke, let's have a baby. That's what I be
and
saying.
That's right? The fuck up. Y'all fucking the game up with that shit. Y'all fucking the game up with some shit like
you
that.
You broke, I'm broke, let's have a baby. Like, yeah, this shit is crazy around this motherfucker. I'm starting to, like.
And then, but crazy, it's like the women nowadays want a nigga that's just, like, so beyond, like you say, out of their league, and it's fucked up because they not doing nothing to, you know what I'm saying, contribute to that, though.
They not.
Like, you get a bitch, you got your own car, you got your own crib, you got this. Bitch, what the fuck?
What do you have? Bitch had with her mama and got 3-4 kids, different baby daddies. And the cold part to me, like, bitch got all these demands. What happened to the last 3 niggas?
That, right, man. You should have learned your motherfucking lesson, bitch.
So all that, you just so all that and all that, and the last 3 niggas, they just left. Like, y'all had a whole baby and everything, and they just...
Skibidi-doo, right out the door.
Got his dumb ass out of here. He gone like Tyrone, you know what I mean? Nigga ain't never come back home, right, some
motherfucker.
Daddy, we got some motherfucking milk.
That's what I'm saying. Y'all getting older. Females is getting older, bro. Y'all can't demand like this. Like I said, a 30-year-old male is not the same as a 30-year-old female. But y'all depreciate. Male don't depreciate till they like 45. They don't.
Like, I heard some shit like, as the realest thing I ever heard, one man can go get 30 females pregnant. He can fuck a bitch every single day and get a different bitch pregnant. Every single day. You understand me? But one female, you can only get pregnant one time, and then you stuck with that for 9 months. So that means you were made to be, like, you know what I mean, submissive to one man.
And they don't understand that.
Like, females, I mean, be submissive to a man. Find you a nigga, I'm about not to cut you off, but find you a nigga and grow with him.
Man.
Find some solid shit. Like, don't just be sitting around just out here fucking. You know what I'm saying? Getting nothing. The only thing y'all gonna get when y'all get done fucking is a nut. And goddamn nothing.
Right,
you know what I'm saying? Don't be out here just doing that. I heard, nigga, bitches don't want to take a nigga to take him to Cheesecake Factory on a goddamn date.
Bitch, you gotta go. I'll take your ass to McDonald's and you say shit like
that. Oh, God, you stupid bitch.
Man, Cheesecake Factory, you crazy.
The Cheesecake Factory. There's no way in Sam Hill y'all ain't fucking with the cheese. Like,
y'all crazy. What? That's what I'm saying. Standards. Like, these motherfucking standards is out of control.
It's out of control.
Bro. Mm-hmm. Out of control.
Bitch, can you take me to Ruth Chris?
Can you take me? Ask yourself, can you
take... Oh, shit, I forgot. I'll do shit and test the bitch. I forgot my wallet. Damn.
Now we both out this bitch. Now we both...
How much money you got?
Crazy. Right. You got... Bet she ain't even got it. You feel me? That's what's crazy, though. Like, you can't
see, just to
something.
See her respond. Oh, hell no, nigga. Oh, yeah, all right. I go to the bathroom on your dumb ass. I don't go on dates with bitches anyways.
How you feel about niggas flying bitches out and they ain't trying to, you know what I'm saying?
And a bitch ain't giving no coochie up.
You feel me?
Ooh. I feel like that's, to me, on
it's
some,
a double standard. On some real shit,
to me, honestly, bro, you're tricking. That goes back to it. And because you're tricking, you think you deserve some pussy. But at the same time, bitch, you know what you was doing.
Exactly.
Once you get there, you might as well get a man a little, just go ahead along with it. Get a man a little piece of coochie. You know what I'm saying? And that way, you will have a good time because you knew what the man wanted when he flew you out like that.
But I understand what you said, but then a lot of females, it's communication. Like, if y'all ain't talking about that shit before, you know what I'm saying? As a nigga.
Real shit.
You can't expect no female to give her your body. You feel me? So if you a real nigga, real Pete, you gonna tell her, yeah. When you get here, I'm cracking.
I'm trying to bust that motherfucker open as soon as you land.
And that's the conversation.
Yeah.
This ain't no, oh, yeah, I'm finna bring you out, spend that $1,500 on you, and hopefully I get some pussy. No, you're gonna hopefully end up empty-handed in this bitch. You feel me?
Yeah, that is a real way.
If you're a real nigga, you're gonna tell me, like, what it is. You feel me? Because this shouldn't be your first rodeo, nigga. If you doing shit like that, you just going out sad. You know what I'm saying? Sad like a glad bag if you're doing some shit like that.
I be seeing niggas doing that, bro.
Man,
niggas will do anything to get some coochie, bro.
Anything. Niggas.
That's some slimy shit, bro. I'm type of nigga, like, I don't really, like, you know, bitch, I'm, like, high class. I'm bougie with my shit. I don't want to just fuck just because. Like, I'm not here. I'd rather be my meat, keep it a band with you. On some real shit. I'm not just, I don't want to just, like, fuck. Yeah, after we're not going to get nothing. Like, I'm not with that. Like, I want to do something. Like, I'm in the new shit. I'm always looking some shit up. I get to showing you some shit. You'd be like, what the fuck is this nigga looking at? What the? Man. I would never thought about no shit like that. So
would you let your girl hit another nigga for some money? Like Adam 22 did?
What? Hell yeah. Adam 22. Is that?
Hey, what?
Adam 22. Y'all gotta understand. What y'all don't understand is, Adam 22, the man is the porn star himself. Him and his bitch.
What? His baby mama though? His wife?
She's a porn star, so that's content. That's pure content. That's you're instantly look. We're talking about it right now. That you're instantly viral.
She only got to fuck women though.
She only had to fuck women at the time, but now she went. And so he thought of what's the most craziest, insanest shit we can think of to do to make us go viral.
Clout is a hell of a drug.
Damn. Hey, yeah. Clout is a hell of a drug. You fuck a fucking black man. They probably sitting there saying, you fucking nigga. Oh my God. Fucking nigga with a dick this long. Oh Lord. Bitch, we gonna go viral.
Real raised Adam wanna act like, man.
He don't give no fuck. Everybody
that nigga was hurt behind this.
He was afterwards, but right. Like, you know what I mean? Especially how the bitch was looking. She enjoyed that shit. Boy, she had a good time.
Hey, you feel me? But hey, it is.
For that bag, they got a bag off that, though. A big one. You know, some people ain't with that. Well, how you feel about, would you let your girl get pregnant for another person?
Oh, like you know, a surrogate?
Yeah, surrogate. What they call that shit? Surrogate? Have a surrogate,
I mean,
baby?
Not me personally, I wouldn't because shit. You feel I wouldn't. But, I mean, I you know. Shit.
You wouldn't let your girl get pregnant for the 50 bands? It'd be like 50 bands.
To carry not my seed? I don't know about that one.
Not your seed. As soon as she shit it out, 50 bands. They get you. Like, I think as soon as she get pregnant, you get like a dub or something like that. And then when she shit, they give you like little breasts. And then when she had a baby, she, you know, have it.
Nah, I'm not doing that shit. I couldn't do it. Nah.
Shit, he on his own.
Hey, he said, yeah. 50 bands.
If she with it, I'm okay with it. I'm just keeping it up. If she okay with it, I'm going to be okay with it. I'm just, you know what I'm saying? 50
so you going to live with, you going to be with your bitch for 9 months. This bitch pregnant.
Hell yeah. Yeah. What? Nigga, 50 bands, I ain't going to lie. It's a lot I can do. You 50 bands ain't exactly. Really ain't a lot of money. But
it ain't
it
a
is.
Lot of money. That's what I'm saying. You going to let your bitch walk around the house. My hormones fucked up.
I'm going to be telling her shit like, you doing all this? That ain't even your baby.
Man,
that ain't your real hormone. You need to call that nigga. What's the nigga name? The real daddy? Call him. You feel me? And had that nigga on speed dial. Soon as you get it tripping on me, I'm going to have that nigga on speed dial. Boop.
You gonna have that bitch stressed the fuck out.
I ain't gonna lie, we gonna be doing fun shit. We gonna be talking about nothing but the 50.
You just wanna hit a pregnant bitch. That's all he wanted. He just wanna. That's just like, motherfucker, I'm gonna hit his pregnant bitch and it ain't my baby. Like
they said, pregnant, I'm gonna be speeding on the little nigga head.
Get his ass in the dimples. You want some dimples? Hold on.
Stupid ass.
That shit crazy.
Ooh, how you feel about motherfucking, what's her motherfucking name? Papoose and Remy Ma.
What's going on with them?
Remy Ma cheated on Papoose. You didn't hear about that?
No, I ain't heard about
man,
that.
Man, the bitch cheated on that nigga, bro. That's the most.
He was in jail?
No, he was out. He stayed down with her through the whole woo-wop.
He let his bitch cheat and he stayed.
He stayed down. He was solid. He was faithful.
Nah, hell,
he was loyal.
That shit ain't solid RP, my boy.
And she cheated. He should have cheated. Yeah. All that time she been busting bitches.
Yeah, now he a real one then, maybe. When she would have passed in a relationship though, it seemed like.
So. Yes, he do.
Feel me? I don't know
that's
about
some,
that.
Ain't no way. I ain't going for no shit like that.
Fuck no.
You know what I'm saying?
How you feel about Nelly and Ashanti spent the block? They got together.
That's cool. That's cool. That's what you call that. Bitches would be like, that's cute. You know what I'm saying? Balls, you know what I mean?
No. And they had a lot of time in the past, but. You know what I'm saying? They both successful artists and shit. But I don't
like
that
bitch
for
real,
nigga. Oh, hell. Well, yeah. They probably. It depends on what they went through.
He really liked her. They look good together, really. Like, I don't know what they did. Like if she cheated on him. What caused them to break up or whatever. But sometimes it's cool to get your bitch back. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
there's a lot of time went by, too. They all matured and shit, so.
They older, you know what I'm saying? Like, they you never know.
Nah, I ain't getting
and Nelly probably dipped on. Nelly, he's a cold nigga. He fucked Floyd Mayweather, bitch.
He did?
He took all the niggas off.
I thought Mayweather fucked his bitch.
No, Nelly
took
his bitch.
Damn, Mayweather got his bitch fucked by a lot.
By everybody, T.I. got his bitch took by.
I don't even know. Don't give me the line type shit.
Hey, we ain't trying to cap on No Cap TV, but you know, it's busting this motherfucker today. You understand me? Off the motherfucking Hennessy. I think I'm going to be drinking Hennessy more often than this motherfucker, bro.
That shit got his ass loose.
You understand me? This bitch got me loose off the goose. I'm loose off the goose. Don't get me started.
Two times at the end, and this bitch in a party.
Baby. How you feel about the Boosie and Webby situation? Like, they don't fuck with each other and shit no more.
I feel like they need to mend that, depending on what happened. They need to mend that, bro, because that's like a, you know what I'm saying, Batman Robin type shit. Like,
Boosie mad because when he went to jail for all that time, nigga, Webby was out making money, doing shows, and putting his face on flyers, and wasn't looking out.
Damn.
That's what I heard, quote unquote, but nigga wasn't looking out. He wasn't looking out for him, and he was making money. He wasn't giving his mama no money, nothing shit like that.
Know,
like,
fucking with that. That ain't no real nigga shit, but you know what I'm saying?
Would you still fuck with a nigga like that? Do some shit like that to you if you get get held down?
If he held me down?
No. If you was to get locked down and your right hand man ain't hold you down.
Nah, I can't fuck with you, man. That's some slimy snake shit. You feel me? Like, you using my name and my image for clout, and you not supporting me while I'm in this bitch locked up. You feel me? That's some hard shit. You feel me?
Boosie did hard time.
He did. You know what I'm saying?
And Boosie's a motherfucker. I like Boosie.
Man, Boosie y'all keep trying to ban Boosie, man. Stop trying to take Boosie Instagram. He said put your pussy lips on live.
Hey, we finna have a motherfucking No Cap girls going wild on this motherfucker.
Wild in
you understand me? We finna bring that shit back and put that motherfucker on the fans or something like that. Had a No Cap TV on the fans.
We bringing y'all a lot of shit. We finna be bringing slap matches. Y'all want to see a nigga get his ass slapped to sleep for $500? Man, I'm talking about black. Ooh. He's so black, he look purple. We finna turn the nigga like that.
You ain't
that,
never seen a nigga get the shit slapped out of him.
You ain't
500.
Never seen it. Bro.
That's a good one.
I want to see a nigga get his head slapped across. Like, I want to see
that on the next show.
I want to see gunshot his ass. Nigga, lay his ass down. How would y'all feel about that?
Would you play that shit?
I wouldn't. I'm paid. What are you talking about? Slap that nigga ass right now. Nigga,
I'm paid.
I'm not a participant. Fuck is you talking about? I'm paying to watch.
Yeah, we're going to have some events coming. I think after this show, we might have some appearances, some motherfucking people we might interview. The next show, we might have some shit busting up.
Okay.
But what you think we got going on? You think we covered everything? Was it a good show today? How you feeling about today?
I feel like we got a little more to talk about, but today the energy is here. Don't get me started.
The Hennessy. I said the energy.
Hennessy and the energy.
The Hennessy got me busting in this bitch, bro. You understand me?
I
want to give a shout out to the motherfucking production.
Production back. You know what I'm saying? Last episode, we kind of slacked off. We had a lot of technical difficulties, but today, we back in effect. You feel me?
You understand me? Oh, I got a question for you.
What's up?
Would you be mad if your homeboy fucked with a female you used to fuck with in the day?
That's a good ass question.
You don't fuck with a bitch no more, and you got a whole nother bitch. You got a whole nother situation going on. But your partner trying to fuck with a bitch you used to fuck with. How would you feel about that?
I wouldn't give a fuck, but he can't be in my face trying to play like he my guy, bro. That's like, well, you feel me? I don't know. That's kind of like some weird ass shit. Like, if that's my right hand man or that's my nigga in my circle, they gonna fuck up with a bitch. He gonna fuck with you. You gonna fuck with a bitch I used to fuck with?
Yeah, real niggas do real shit.
I don't know.
Ain't no shit you don't do.
There's too many bitches out here, but you feel me? That just make me second guess your character at this point.
Hey, at this point, nigga, you know what I'm saying?
There's too many bitches out here. We gonna go get one I have. Fuck wrong with you.
Like that. What's that movie? Love it. Love it. It's too deep.
Out of pocket. Hey, well, John, that's crazy.
How you feel about these? Shout out to my fucking brother.
That shit be beating his ass all day.
Every show, this motherfucker be busting me. You know what I'm saying? Hey, I wish I could tell you who my plug is. You understand me?
That bitch is able to
talk. We in Arizona, weed is recreational. That's what we need to talk about. How you feel about that? Recreational marijuana in Arizona.
The cold thing is, y'all know I don't smoke, I don't drink. So, everybody I know around me, I've been around weed so long in my life. You know what I'm saying? I'm high off nature. Naturally high because it's the smoke.
High
so
off life.
Well, hey, I don't give a fuck, man. If you're gonna do any drug, weed, you know, that's smooth. That's an herb.
I feel like if you're gonna do any drug, you should brought that's about it. It's weed.
Yeah. So
use some good weed. Sometimes people need to smoke some weed.
Yeah.
You never know that you need to smoke a blunt.
You think weed fuck with niggas' intelligence?
But look, one time I had stuff. It do. It really do because if you don't smoke weed,
shit fries your brain. Shit.
You, if you don't smoke weed and you smoke some powerful shit,
that shit might.
I had stopped smoking weed for like, I just wanted to see if I can do it. I had to stop smoking weed cold turkey just to see, you know, if I'm stronger than weed.
I wanted to see if I was stronger.
I don't know, you know, motherfuckers be fiending for shit, like, you know what I mean? So I just quit cold turkey. And every now and then, periodically, nigga, I would hit the blunt one time, nigga, and that motherfucker had me like...
out of there.
Zooted it, nigga, like, what?
It just lowers your tolerance, right?
Yes, it's like when you stop smoking, after a while, for it takes like 30 days to get weed out your system.
30 days.
Straight. Boom. I would say... for the first week, it take 1 week to stop smoking weed. The first 2 days, you're going to be going through, you're going to eat no food, none of that shit. You're going to be sick, damn near, like, damn, I can't eat nothing. Then after the third, fourth day, nigga, you don't start eating, and, you know what I mean? But, I would say 60 days, your tolerance is damn near to, like, neutral, nigga. So when you hit a blend, it's, like, almost the first time again.
That's smooth.
And it feel like, nigga, what? Don't smoke no. It's like you off of some psychedelic shit.
Psychedelic.
I hit the blend, like, oh, shit.
How you feel about, like, designer drugs and shit? Like, you know, everybody doing, like, pharmaceutical drug perks.
I feel like them niggas is followers, bro.
Definitely.
You hear a song and a nigga talking about, pop up 30 today. I pop the perk today.
Perk 30 for you, my nigga. You feel me?
You do perks?
Hell nah, man. That's crazy.
This nigga stupid.
I work with the perks.
This nigga said, hey,
I don't do no perks. That's how the nigga told the nigga
right on the interview. You do perks? Stupid ass nigga. Hell no. No motherfucking perks, nigga.
How you, I mean, how you, but
I feel like that's just, you know, people is, like we said before, I think that was on the first episode, it's motherfuckers that's meant to be leaders, and it's motherfuckers that's meant to be followers. You know?
There's a lot more followers in this world. So.
And there's a lot of more followers in this world, and if you're going to follow the trigger, why are you popping the perk for? Your back don't hurt. where the fuck did you get that from?
Right.
Who told you that popping the perk was cool? Because that's what I feel like. Low-key, I feel like if celebrity and all that shit influence is crazy. Yeah. If celebrities were smoking crack and crazy shit like that,
they'd do it.
Because that's how, back in the day, that's how it was. Like, motherfuckers was... The celebrities were smoking crack. It was okay. And that's like Whitney Houston. I love her to death. Like, rest in peace, Whitney Houston. But she was smoking Krenak. Because that was a thing to do.
What you need?
I need a lighter.
That opioid epidemic, man.
That shit was crazy.
You know
what
this
shit
was crazy, bro.
They got fentanyl and everything.
Now, people want the
Fetty,
though. People want the Fetty.
Motherfucker want the Fetty, nigga.
We're gonna post a patch of Fetty, nigga.
I used to fuck with Fetty Wap heavy, the artist. That was my nigga. You feel me? But then when they came out with the Fetty Wap, the drug,
man,
fucked me up. Niggas dying. Like, why would you want to take some shit and you know you could damn near really did not?
Let's talk about these niggas that's addicted to the fentanyl pills versus a crackhead. See, I fuck with all the crackheads.
Yeah, crackheads.
Crackheads got the energy. They gonna do whatever.
They gonna clean your car. They gonna fix some shit.
They mental is there, nigga.
Yeah, the mental is there.
Niggas off the fatty, they ass burnt out, nigga. They stuck, they retarded, they slow.
Niggas be outside sleeping in Arizona, nigga. In 140 degrees, nigga, in the summertime.
In a full hoodie and a beanie, niggas is wild.
Crackheads were so cool in my neighborhood, bro. That's some crazy shit. Fentanyl, they can do everything, nigga.
Crackhead know how to do literally everything, nigga.
He know how to paint
your whole motherfucking house for $10, nigga. Yeah, paint your house, vacuum. Don't let the nigga.
That nigga got everything you need.
Yeah, lawnmower.
Pop up with some random shit. You didn't even know you needed it. Right. Here, Nip, y'all got the speaker for you.
Man, and like, they cool as hell, man. They super talented, and it's crazy because they mind is still there.
But kids. Please, say no to drugs.
Say no to drugs, kids.
I would just say, like...
You be like Rico, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm sober. I'm high.
It's not, you know, if do you, it's okay to be you. If just because your friends are popping pills and, you know what I mean, cracking seals, and you know what I mean? Even smoking weed, I smoke weed. This is my thing. I smoke weed. I've been smoking. My mama smoked weed. Everybody smoked weed. They smoke weed when I... You hear me? I've been around weed for a long time. I've been smoking weed since we've been weed.
Exactly.
But... This is what I do. But don't smoke weed just because you see a nigga doing it or because you think it's cool or nothing. You
I
know,
go with anything in life, though, man.
Be like yourself, bro. You know what I'm saying? And lead your own path. And I swear to God, it'll take you to somewhere you never even knew. Like, doing your own shit. You be like, damn, how am I even doing some new shit?
Yeah.
Tap into some new shit.
Tap into
in the world.
Yeah.
What's going on in Arizona right now?
Shit. You know November.
It's still hot as hell. The weather is great around this bitch. Thanksgiving is coming up. I can't wait to go motherfucker go eat. Nigga, what? I'm finna be. I'm going to my mama house.
Y'all be fucking with. Hey, it's crazy. Thanksgiving one of your favorite holidays?
Damn near, I swear.
Niggas just hungry, huh? He was down. Look, the niggas, he been starving himself since the beginning of the year.
I ain't even waiting for November. I'm stopping right now, today. I ain't eating till Thanksgiving. And and my son's birthday is around Thanksgiving, too. Usually, sometimes his birthday be dropping on Thanksgiving. That should be tight. So, I'm going to take him out there to see my mama and shit. I take him out there every year to see my mama and hang out. We do some cool shit. Like,
that's just cool. The year over though, that's crazy. 2024 flew
it's
by, man.
I'm talking about what?
Man,
Cyril, it's about to be 2024, and it's okay, almost so over.
How you feel about people having like their New Year's resolutions? Do you think they should wait till 24?
I feel like start now.
Yeah, I'm gonna say
fuck that bullshit. Fuck waiting.
It's a mental thing.
Do it now. It's mind over matter. Damn. I always feel like if you gonna let that beat you. You know what I mean? It don't even take 21 days to stop a habit. Man, or start a habit.
Yeah, start
form you a new habit. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? How could you, if you smoke cigarettes, I didn't smoke cigarettes because I thought they was cool. I ain't gonna lie, being in school and shit, I smoked a cigarette, I thought they was cool. But after a while, I'm like, that shit ain't cool. I'm not smoking no cigarette and quit cold turkey. Just threw my whole pack out the window and said I wasn't gonna smoke them no more. And never smoke a cigarette again. Like,
yeah.
You know what
I
mean?
If anybody got any New Year's resolution, man, like I said, I hope y'all sticking to it.
Stick to it.
Like I said, last episode, set a standard for yourself. You know what I'm saying? I don't be gambling no more. Y'all know I'm a
big
gambler.
I think we gonna name this one that. Set a standard.
Y'all know I be gambling. You know what I'm saying? I don't gamble no more. You know what I'm saying? That shit is for real, bro. Like, I really stopped cold turkey. I almost had a relapse today. It's Sunday. So I almost had a relapse, but I set a standard. You know what I'm saying? Because I can't be doing that shit. You feel me?
You gotta quit gambling. If you're losing your money, you ain't.
Hey,
you know what I'm saying?
I'll be winning and losing. But I feel like you can't, you feel me? You can't beat the house type shit. So sometimes you can, but you know what I'm saying? You gotta go broke. You know what I'm saying? That gambling, get it out the system. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Lil Baby, man. But yeah.
Ooh, let's talk about when niggas get to capping when bitches come around.
Ooh, that shit crazy. Because nigga cap his ass. Oh,
oh my God. Hey, when you gonna get my shirt back, bro?
Nigga put everything. Nigga do they man so dirty.
You like my shoes, bro? Man, Rico.
Man, they do they man so dirty for
a few niggas. Out of my nigga, like, what the fuck?
Crazy,
stop
man.
Doing y'all partners dirty man, for some
you supposed
pushy,
to be looking
bro.
Out. If them your homies, you supposed to be looking out for your man, man, for real.
Stop doing that shit, bro. Niggas a cap
that
for
shit
a bitch.
Crazy.
How would you, okay, look, I got a question for you. Yeah. If say you 25 minutes away from your crib, right?
Yep.
And your man's meet you at your house, and your girl there, do we got to wait outside, or can she let him in? And he can't.
Ooh, that's a good. I mean, shit. I mean, I've been in both situations where, like if I don't really know my homie girl like that, I'll wait outside the car. But if I tell my homie I'm finna be there, he'd be like, just go in the crib, man. Like, I'll be there in a minute. Yeah. But like, it depends on what kind of relationship you got with your nigga and what kind of character like your nigga seen. If you ain't got that kind of character, your nigga not going.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And he know his girl is how she is, and he know how his man is.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It depends, but I wouldn't. I mean, me personally, I'd probably just wait in the car in this day and age. But
you as yourself. Yeah, me too. I probably like, unless my nigga say, yeah, go in the crib, woo, woo. Yeah. Like, you can go chill. He got a spot in the crib where we go chill at or whatever fuck. And go in there, and you go chill until I get there or whatever.
Yeah, you should.
But I think I'll wait outside until my nigga get there. Like, whatever. Yeah. Like, I don't want to be around my nigga girl like that. Like,
yeah.
Ain't nothing I wouldn't do. We can be cool. It's cordial, but.
Yeah. I get it. For sure. Yeah.
Well, I think we're going to wrap it up, man.
Yeah, man.
What do you think? This is it.
Man, this is episode 3 of No Cap TV, man. We appreciate y'all, man. Please like, comment, subscribe. We appreciate our production crew for sticking with us, you know what I'm saying, tapped in with us, and man, like I said, we appreciate y'all for tuning in, man.
I appreciate y'all, motherfuckers.
Hey, it's your boy Hollywood Reek, man.
It's your boy, motherfucking YC.
It's No Cap TV, bitch.
Bow!
Hold up.
Boom!
Yeah, man, that's the way. Are we about to bust this trick? Man, just like telling me that with you, I'm gonna show up too. And she don't know what to do. Thank you.